Mondays on Bethany Hall. A whole bunch of other fucking great people. I'm Murph, and if you don't think I'm aware I got barbecue sauce all over my pants, you are sadly mistaken. Now let's give it up for our host, Chris Gethard.
Show. I'm your host, Chris Gethard. We want to say hi to everybody watching live on MNN, everybody watching live at thechrisgethardshow.com, as well as anybody who might be downloading this in the future. So you can see we've got a packed panel tonight. One of our fan base's favorite events has returned after, I think, well over a year. Ladies and gentlemen, I don't want to waste any time. Tonight is the return of the Night of Zero Laughs. Oh, sorry about that. I jumped the ending. I apologize.
He just left.
Oh, no. We'll explain all the rules. first, I just want to quickly welcome everybody who's here. Thank you guys all for coming out, taking your time to compete in this very important and serious event. These, I think, are a lot of the funniest people in New York City, and we're all going to be here refusing to let laughter be a part of the evening. And I know some of you guys know each other, some of you don't. I see that Grizz already has his game face on. Grizz is here, ladies and gentlemen. This is the fifth Night of Zero Laughs we're doing. It's the third one on Public Access. Grizz lasted very long on our first Public Access one. You were the first person eliminated in the second one. Tonight is a night of redemption for you.
You guys cheated on the
second one. It was kind of bullshit. And you drove kind of a long way to get here. I felt really bad. Next to Grizz, we have, of course, one of my favorite improvisers, and you recently saw him make his Daily Show debut. Jordan Klepper is here.
Centering myself.
You're already summoning some seriousness, I can
I'm
see.
I'm trying to. I think of very sad, terrible things. Right.
Okay. Sad, terrible things before the show even starts. Sitting to my right, one of my favorite people. We do a show. We're doing a show together this Saturday. I'm psyched. One of the most brilliant comedic minds I've ever come across, Tammy Sager. How are you?
Cried twice today, so I feel good.
Okay, an early front runner. Sitting to my left, your first time at the Chris Gethard Show. I feel like in the world, our fans, I think, know all of your work very well. This is a man I've known for many years.
All of your work.
I think so. I think they know.
Sure, no, that just sounds like what you say to somebody when you don't know any of their work. Oh, I love all of your work. Yeah, sure, thing and the other thing. And that book, oh, man, that book was amazing.
I want to say this has been a thing developing between us. Wyatt Cenac is here, ladies and gentlemen. And I'll tell you, we are... When we are not in front of other people, we are friends.
We are genuinely, we care for each other, but when the camera cuts on, we are like Hulk Hogan and Macho Man Randy Savage.
It's
true. We have a job to do.
True.
And that job is to wrestle with our minds.
And decided that. I want to be clear. You decided that.
Because I felt like it would be better for both of our careers.
Fair. I need it.
Do I
do need it.
Talking to this? Has no one heard anything I've said?
Probably, yeah. It's hard
Did
to
I
mic
not
all
even
these people.
Get a microphone?
No, there's mics right above our head. And I have one, a lav on me. You can hear it.
So wait, did people just... This feels like a thing where I'm the only person who was given a microphone to record. What is this? Okay. Am I just doing to a separate, am I doing a separate podcast to within
it's
your
not
show?
A podcast, it's a TV show.
I assume it's a TV show, but I don't know why I have a microphone.
Okay, we gotta get all these other people introed, man.
Sure, okay. But am I doing Mark Maron's podcast right now?
You're just doing the Chris Gethard show. This is how it works. We're okay. Not it's not a well-organized thing.
Okay, thanks.
Welcome.
Chris.
Thank
and
you
Mark,
for being
it's
here.
It's great to be here.
Sitting to Wyatt's left, here's our friend. He is a guy who's been on the show, forever, from day one. He also is a huge part of the show, and we're hoping the American government will recognize that and give him an artist visa. Juan, how are you? Welcome back to the show.
I'm looking good. I'm looking dandy. All good.
Good. Feeling good. Up above you, our internet liaison, Bethany Hall. How you feeling?
I'm feeling great.
That
and
is good.
Sad.
Great and sad. One of my favorite people in New York comedy. I've had a comedy crush on this guy since the first time I saw him perform a couple years ago. He is one of the best stand-ups I know. You've seen him recently crushing it on Last Comic Standing. America's falling in love with him over the past few weeks. Joe Mackey is here. Joe, how are you?
I was just thinking about when he compared you two to Hulk Hogan and Macho Man.
Oh,
Randy
no.
Savage, that Macho Man Randy Savage is dead.
I will be out the first time Joe speaks. Everything he says makes me laugh. Alyssa, you are here. Horatio Sanz is not here yet, so you have taken a seat. Our teenage underdog contestant, how you feeling?
Loving being a second choice.
Loving being a second choice. Welcome to my world, my friend. Michael O'Brien is here, one of my favorite improvisers. Saw him this year on SNL. He's behind 7 Minutes in Heaven, one of the great internet series of all time. Michael, how are you feeling about the Night of Zero Laughs?
I think my agent may have misled me.
Griffin Newman, the man behind Talking TCGS, an accomplished actor in his own right. Griffin, how you doing?
I've had a tough week.
Tough week. Good to know. Making his return, a TCGS OG, inexplicably holding a French horn. Welcome back to the Chris Gethard Show, Will Hines, ladies and gentlemen.
Thank you. It's great to be here.
Wonderful. Great to see you too, man. And of course, holding down the back row by himself, you met him before, Murph is here. Murph, I'm sure you're going to do great. Now let's introduce our referees, Mr. Anthony Apruzzi, the Bayonne Bruiser, and Fred from Honolulu. Walk on over here, gentlemen. You guys are entrusted to control it. So we just want to go over all the rules so everybody here is clear on what's expected of us. Anthony will blow a whistle that will signal when we are not allowed to laugh. Anthony, please film anything that I am misled on or missing. Please let me know. I believe the rule is this. If you laugh outright, Fred and Anthony will give you a red card. You are dismissed from the show. If you are smirking, trying to obscure your face, or doing something that they judge to be an effort to hide from a laugh that is inside you, you will get a yellow card as a warning.
Also, if you try to block your face, you will get a yellow card. And years passes with people putting water bottles, paraphernalia up to their face. It's not going to fly tonight. Your hands go up to your face, you get a yellow card. Get two yellow cards, you hit the bricks.
You're out. There's no gum chewing and no water drinking allowed. If you have gum, please spit it out now. What else? When you are eliminated, if you are eliminated, you will be given a microphone. You will be allowed to try to take down people with you. You'll have about 30 seconds to do or say whatever you want to try to ruin other people's fun and also get them out.
I might also, if you're grinning for an extended period of time, give you a certain allotted amount of time to pull it together. Maybe 7 seconds, maybe 14 seconds. Depends on how hard you're trying to keep it together.
And you will choose if people's smiles are of amusement or just general pleasure. Mm-hmm. That's up to your discretion as well.
Sometimes I might give Fred the call on that one too. Right, Fred?
All right. And tonight, what we're playing for, whoever wins will get this packet of Hi-Chew candies that I bought at a deli on the way here. Anthony, I'll trust this to you. If there's multiple winners, we'll split those up. Are there any questions about the rules before we begin? Yes, Wyatt.
Can I eliminate myself now?
You just don't want to be a part of this?
Well, I thought it was a better gift than Hi-Chew. I didn't know it was gum.
It's not gum. You swallow it. It's like wax.
That's even worse.
It's like a Japanese Starburst.
Yeah, exactly.
I don't even like American Starburst.
It seems like rules-wise, we're all in the clear.
Wyatt, I'll bet you $5 that I last longer than you do.
Wow.
Is that a
$5 bet? Side bet. We're actually not allowed to gamble on M&M. We can't.
I take it back.
Okay. Okay, if there's no other concerns or questions, from the point Anthony blows his whistle, laughter will not be allowed. We'll go to the... Okay. Okay, the night of zero laughs has begun. Let's go to the phones right away. David in California, welcome to the show.
Hi.
Hi, David. It's good to talk to you again.
Yeah, it's good to talk to you, too. So first off, I was just hoping that you could do some posing so I can get a good picture of the striped shirt.
That's okay. David runs a Tumblr called Chris Gethard Striped Shirts, where he posts photos of me wearing striped shirts, which I like.
Okay, stay there for a while, because there's a really long delay.
That was for you, David. So what else do you want to talk about tonight? We can feel a grim cloud falling over this group of people. I see Michael O'Brien already.
I wanted to say, I just wanted to quickly say hi to Wyatt.
Oh, that's great. Fan?
Hi, how are you, man?
Hey, I'm good. I saw you last year at Outside Lands during Paul McCartney's set, and it was awesome.
Oh, thank you. That was weird. Just because, do I need this microphone?
You don't
again?
Need it, just for safety's sake.
So, Marin, the thing about, I performed at Outside Lands, and you were like one of the seven people that stayed because I was going opposite Sir Paul McCartney. And what I learned was that people really like Paul McCartney. Yeah, I mean, I had seven people. You were one of them, so thank you.
You're welcome. I really enjoyed that show.
Thank you. You enjoyed watching a man break. a man's spirit get broken by a beetle. At least it wasn't
Ringo,
though.
The sad part was when people got up in the middle of the show.
That's what sucked, was the people, not just the people who got up in the middle, the people who got up for Wings songs. Like, it's fine to leave me for Paul McCartney Beatle, but if you walk out on Live and Let Die, go fuck yourself.
Joe Mackey, you're smirking.
You have four seconds to pull it together. First yellow card.
Four.
Joe, they're giving me 4 seconds to get
three,
a neutral face.
Two, one. All right, he's good. One yellow card to Joe Mackey.
Joe Mackey is on a yellow card. Just remember that, Fred, you'll remember that.
I'm just wondering how many high chews are in a pack.
Yeah, is it just one high chew and it's your responsibility to cut them into little pieces for you and your friends? Or do you just take it like a stick of butter? Is it like a waxy stick of butter that you just jam down your gullet?
No, there's about seven. They're individually wrapped.
Could you melt them together like a giant stick of butter if you wanted?
I'm sure you could.
Chris, I'm curious if you know if high chew is manufactured at a factory where there might be traces of nuts. I have a nut allergy. I just want to ask on behalf of all the other people on the panel.
That's a good question.
I don't know.
I think that's a very good question.
Wyatt is gently touching me, and I'm not sure why.
Because my shoulder itches, and sometimes I think if my shoulder itches, other people's shoulders itch.
Let's go ahead to Orlando and New York on the phones. Orlando, are you there?
Why are you rubbing my shoulder like you're jerking off?
Hey, I'm here.
Orlando, what did you want to talk about tonight?
Well, you said to have a game plan. I want to see something really weird that maybe can get a laugh, or maybe I'll have something to jerk off later, too.
Okay, you want something to jerk off to later is what you're saying?
Or we'll make you laugh, I don't know. But can I get Noah Foreman to lick Anthony Appuzzi's head while Will Hines comforts them both and tells them, "It's okay, son. I love you."
Anthony, are you okay with that? Are you okay with Noah Foreman licking your head?
As long as no one laughs, I'm fine with it.
Okay, Noah. Noah, would you like to come forward? One of our head writers, Duke Ponzetti, Noah Foreman, played by our head writer, Duke Ponzetti. Noah, so it's a request that you lick Anthony's head and will you comfort them like a father? I'm going to ask everybody on the panel if we can watch this directly, no dodging.
Is MNN okay with this?
Totally fine.
Because this seems a little porny.
that not up there
flies
yet.
Here, man.
Please don't obstruct my vision.
You gotta watch Sub-Zero TV. The show After Hours is Sub-Zero TV. It's just like...
It's just about Sub-Zero refrigerators?
It's just straight up pussy.
Oh, wow.
It's like close-ups of assholes and stuff.
Just
it's great.
Fucking do this. It's so fucking disgusting.
Great, let's do it. So Noah, let's everybody watch it.
This bit, bitch.
Orlando, relax.
Can't decide if I want to do the little hair part or the little fresh part.
I say go little hair part. It's like French kissing a cat.
Everything is all right. Everything is all right. Everything's gonna be all right.
Yeah, that's good. That's good. That's good. No, it's good. You're like
the Christmas story. You just got stuck to his head.
You're like cats. You're just being like cats to each other.
Okay, thank you, Will. Thank you, Noah.
Thank you, Chris.
The most obscene thing about that was the French horn, yes?
The most Will obscene thing that about horn? That was the French horn that Will Hines, again, inexplicably showed up with the French horn.
Chris, I'd like to say that was Orlando in New York, correct?
Yeah, that was Orlando in New York.
Because I thought Orlando in New York was Chelsea Piers.
That was like a tight 10 seconds.
I'm being given an envelope by Emma Noble, one of our writers. I've been told any envelope I get, I should open it, and we should do what we are asked inside. So this says, I cannot read this out loud without laughing.
Do you want someone to read it for you?
If anyone could read this.
Kick the crutches away from scoliosis, Alf.
So I, Alf.
There he comes.
And scoliosis adult Alf is on his way. We have to kick away his crutches.
Is it just up to anybody who's feeling froggy?
Anyone who wants can kick Alf's scoliosis crutches.
Maybe if you could walk, you'd still have a TV show.
Alf is crying. It's Alf is screaming so genuinely.
Why? I want to do it too.
Tammy, Wyatt, Tammy also wants to beat Alf with a crutch. Yeah.
Oh, or just kick him out again. Can you get back on the crutches?
Let me help you up. Let me help you up, buddy.
Alf did? Yeah.
Thank you, Grizz.
I don't...
Thank you, Grizz.
Gethard yellow card.
Yeah.
You're chuckling.
Yeah. I did. I chuckled. You Alf. Are right. I did chuckle.
Hey, Alf.
Oh, God.
I heard you like to eat pussy. I need a test.
Would anyone else like a chance to kick crutches out from Alf?
You okay?
Okay, an audience member was hit.
He hit his head on my knee.
Alf could legitimately be very hurt right now.
What is Alf wearing under his costume?
I guess purple boxer briefs.
Is your health care, do you have health care here or is it back in Melmac? I'm just saying, if you're screwed here, like, that's a long trip back to Melmac.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, our musical guest tonight is the only tension break we will have from the Night of Zero Laughs. We're all allowed to get up, dance, whatever we want, or you can hang back. but I hope our studio audience gets up and dances. They have a show July 19th at an undisclosed location in Bushwick. They're about to play a song from their EP. Their second song will be from their upcoming album. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Low Fat Getting High.
You okay?
Banana Man, what'd you think of that?
That's one of my favorite songs of all time.
One of your favorite songs of all time. Amazing. Okay. Banana Man loving it. Alyssa getting back to her seat. So far, I have a yellow card. Joe Mackey has a yellow card. No one has been outright eliminated. I want to go to line two if we can. One of my favorite callers. We haven't heard from her in a while. Anna, down in Brazil. How's it going down there?
Hey, how are you guys?
How are you?
I don't know what to do. What?
I'm good. How are you doing?
I'm good. It's hard not to laugh. Many people are saying and doing funny things. Grizz is doing much better than last time. Grizz, you look cold as ice.
Yeah, Grizz is a rock right now. He's not working at all.
You want some of those high chews?
No, sir.
No. You will refuse the high chews.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Hello?
Yeah, Anna, what do you want from us?
I'm a big fan from 7 Minutes in Heaven with Michael Bryan. So I was wondering if Mike and Brian would guess you like he does on the show. Really weird.
There's a request from a girl in Brazil that you kiss me real weird. I don't know if you're into that.
Yeah, I do that.
Yeah, you wanna, are we doing a lean over? You watch this one.
Hold on, let me get this.
You watch this.
Picture of this.
Okay.
I feel like this should be an easy no laugh. It's gonna be a serious, real kiss.
Can you guys hold each other really close when you do it?
I gotta get proof. Hold on.
We're gonna let what happens happen. I've improvised with you for
years.
Five, 6 years.
Yeah.
Through that time, I found you to be informative, inspiring, and through your own good posture, swagger, sexy.
Thank you.
So,
I told you when you first moved to New York that I had seen you perform in Chicago, and you blew me away. And I'll say, when you see someone command the stage like that, there's a part of you that will never be able to resist them.
Can you take off your glasses, Chris?
Notebook style.
Also, I don't know if you know this. That's my fiance.
I'm gonna look at her when this happens.
Not happy about the eye contact.
Yeah, your roommate seems more bummed out than your fiance.
She's also, they're the same.
Wait, your roommate's your fiance?
Yeah, we live
together.
Do
you introduce your fiance as your roommate?
We've already been through
this. Because that seems really like you're ashamed of your fiance. Or you're ashamed of your roommate. It depends on you're ashamed of your apartment or of marriage.
I said it once on the show, not thinking, and people have been giving me shit ever since. So now I try to bring it up to empower, to have some power over it.
I'm sorry that I hadn't watched your show before I agreed to do it.
Have you ever seen a second of this show? You can be honest.
I've never even seen you perform.
Oh. We've performed in shows.
I know, and I black out most of it. Like, I don't even know what's going on half the time. I remember other people, but I just have a weird Chris Gethard block.
Who else? Joe Mackey, you have not been on the show. Have you ever seen this show?
First time on the show, I have seen bits and pieces of it. It's a very good show. I like it a lot. I think you guys are doing some good stuff.
But you only like it in a bits and pieces kind of way. Like, you've never seen a whole show.
You've never sat through a whole episode.
I think we should all change the subject.
Well, no, I'm just saying, the way you're saying I've only seen it in bits and pieces, you sound like somebody who's like, oh, I love TED Talks. And you're like, oh, yeah, which one? Well, the 3 minutes of that one about nuclear physics.
But that's still 3 minutes more than you've seen.
Right. But I'm not.
Be clear who's giving
shit. Jordan Klepper, first time on the show. Have you seen this show before?
Bits and pieces.
Everyone's a bits and pieces guy.
They've been very good bits, and the pieces are
you should just do your show as bits and pieces. That's the way people seem to want to consume it. They just bring people in for like 5 minutes on a Wednesday night, and then like, all right, everybody, go home. We'll see you next Wednesday.
I have noticed most people who watch things on the internet don't want them to be an hour long.
I've watched entire episodes of the show.
I know, Griffin, you have a podcast that analyzes each episode of the show.
I've seen episodes, too.
Alyssa, you've been watching from the start. You called episode one. I know you have seen it. When did you first call?
Wow, you don't even know your own show. That's harsh.
We've had like 150 episodes. Why are you targeting me so specifically?
I'm just saying, well, one, because if you're gone, then there's a vacuum, and I don't have a show right now. Jordan took my job, so...
Is there tension there?
There's a lot of tension. That's why there's two people between us.
I prefer the distance.
Yeah.
The chat rats are saying that they want more Tammy.
The chat rats want more Tammy? Okay, let's give them up to Tammy. Yeah. Tammy, chat rats asking for any random Tammy that you want to give them.
I kind of want... this is fucked up.
What do you want, Tammy?
I wanted you and Wyatt to kiss. But that's really fucked up of me to ask.
Wyatt and Jordan.
Yeah, let's kiss.
A Daily Show correspondent and a former Daily Show correspondent about to kiss live on public access television in what has to be one of the sadder moments of both of their lives.
Getting the job at the Daily Show was one of the most exciting things that happened in my life. And a mere 4 months later to come on to community access and to be forced to kiss somebody who had your job It's humiliating.
Whose job you stole?
This is like watching David Tennant kiss Christopher Eccleston.
What? What?
Doctor.
We are the Doctor Who's. I gotta get on the chair. You're a tall.
That's a Doctor Who reference?
Yeah. You don't know that, Chris?
I just want to know, Gethard is more excited than he is laughing.
Okay, okay. I thought I laughed, personally.
Can I make a request? Chris, while this kiss happens, I'm going to be looking at your roommates.
Hi, Gethard. You got to go, Gethard.
I'm out.
You're my
time. After the side and help commentate. So, Jordan, you're going to be making direct eye contact with my fiance while you kiss Wyatt.
And I'm going to make direct eye contact with you.
I love that I can laugh now. It feels so good to not have to be doing that. Look at Joe Mackey. He's so close.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Mackey's so close. Mackey's so close.
Stop delaying the issue.
Ready for this? Sure. I would like to do this Queensberry Dutch rules where you hold me.
Okay, I want chat rats, meme this. Chat rats, gift this shit right now. Meme this shit, man. This shit'll spread on Tumblr.
What is your eye line? Because if I go right,
I can see Gethard. Okay. I can see Gethard.
Why?
Right now.
I can vouch that we are making direct eye
contact. Top lip hair is gonna touch
his.
What do you mean?
Yeah, where do I have to position so that we can have a weird quasi foursome?
I need to move into
your sight line. Back with Meanie on the hoops, the wonderful Meanie on the hoops.
Can we get some music too?
Mm-hmm. LLC music
can
request.
Can you also lift me up a little bit here? Bethany!
Bethany is out!
Yellow card.
Bethany has a yellow card. Joe Mackey and Bethany with yellow cards. Everyone else thus far safe.
What up, Joe Mackey?
Okay.
And if there was any doubt before, Wyatt has been smoking marijuana.
New rule. Michael O'Brien and Alyssa have to hold hands for the rest of the show.
Okay, Michael O'Brien, you are holding hands with a teenage fan of yours. That's a smirk if I ever saw one.
Oh,
Who? Yellow card?
You have 7 seconds to pull it together or else you're out.
7 seconds in heaven, O'Brien.
Seven. Six. Five.
O'Brien, four, Alyssa looks actually
three,
angry.
Two.
O'Brien is out! Okay.
Can I say something about this whole deal?
Michael O'Brien, this is the floor is yours. You can try to take
anyone
with you.
Yeah, either way, whether give it to me or not, Gethard. Bad kisser. And all of you, get health insurance! Look at you, jobless America.
Why?
You disgrace me. What? Anna from Brazil probably has a job. What do you do? Nothing.
Michael, why are you lacing
one
into
for
our fans?
One.
Why are you lacing into our very nice fans?
Yeah, I guess they're all right. I guess it's more this motherfucker. Hi. Fuck you. I'm on real TV.
Wow. And he's out. Michael O'Brien, that is how you make an exit.
If I had a ghost
Let's get Connor a mic. Connor, what
Oh, no, I have a mic attached to me.
So what brings you out here tonight, Connor?
Well, you know, I'm you know, everyone can kind of relax. I'm not going to try to make anybody laugh. I'm not really part of the comedic element of the show. I've always been part of the aspirational / inspirational part of the show. So I'm really just out to just sort of take a moment to salute. We're helping a lot of people tonight with this. And
Connor,
I don't know
can I interrupt you?
Yeah.
You were trying to be on the Olympic team for Ireland.
Yeah.
You were wearing socks with the Puerto Rican flag.
Yeah.
Joe Mackey. Okay. Connor, I'm going to have to interrupt you. Okay. Joe Mackey, the floor is yours. You can try to take anyone with you. Joe Mackey targeting Chris. Are we going to have a third kiss? Joe Mackey attempting to kiss Chris.
Is it his 30 seconds over?
Is it his 30 to wait seconds this out. Over? Tammy covering her mouth. I saw that.
I'm hands down. I'm still stone straight.
Joe Mackey sadly walks away in rejection. Sadly rejected. Hands down. Joe, are you okay?
I'm okay.
New rule, they have to kiss.
Oh, wow. Okay.
Starting after this, no.
Okay, Joe is gone. Joe has opted to not follow through on the kiss.
For Grizz to stay in, he
Joe,
has to
Joe, thank
kiss
you
him.
For being on the show. A true honor. You will not eat any high chews
he to kiss. Tonight.
He got shy. Joe can get shy.
Kiss him.
Okay, Connor, your floor is yours again.
At the beginning, I don't know, I didn't, maybe I missed the part where everyone talked about the charities that they're doing this for.
Who we?
Yellow card to Alyssa.
A yellow card for Alyssa. You're not allowed to argue the refs, Alyssa.
All right.
You're gone.
Wow! Wow! A huge move! Not taking shit anymore. Alyssa, the floor is yours. You can try to take anyone with you. Alyssa, how old are you these days?
18,
okay. Yeah.
Fucking white men need to relax.
Somebody's in college now.
Whatever she says next is true.
Thank you.
A dream comes true here tonight. Murph, do you want to move up? Maybe, Murph, move up to my seat.
One of these death chairs.
Yeah, drop you down a little more into the action. Wyatt is ruthless, I'll tell you that.
No, I miss Alyssa. Hashtag bring back our girls.
Oh, Juan?
Ooh. It's like 20% Juan. Of the smirk.
You got 5 seconds.
Ooh, Fred has the yellow card out. Fred's waiting to give you a yellow card, Juan.
No. No yellow card.
Clear. Okay. I'm going to go to the phones. I'm going to go ahead and go to Max in Florida. Max, welcome to the show.
Hey.
Hey, Max, what do you want?
I was wondering if the panel could do their best Beatles impression.
Best Beatles impression. This may sting for Wyatt. As we know, no one watched him during Paul McCartney.
7 people watched me. 7 people, including one of your viewers. But what, you're saying your viewers are nobodies?
I didn't say that.
That's why this chair is empty now. That's why there's a vacuum here, because you think your viewers are nobodies. I think everyone in the audience now should boo Mr. Gethard.
This.
the thing about zero laughs doesn't mean it should be the night of zero love.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, so everyone.
I'll do something to get booed. That'll get booed.
Okay, you'll do
this
something.
This is my Beatles impression.
Okay.
Seven seconds to pull it together.
Bethany, you are so fucking goddamn. You know it, Bethany.
Five.
Bethany, you are so fucking out of here.
Three.
You are so God.
One.
You did it.
What? Yeah. What? I thought you guys were going to be tough, man. I thought you guys were going to be tough, man. That's why we hired you.
Death isn't funny.
All right.
Okay.
Who wants it?
Okay.
I'll take it.
Griffin, do you want... Oh, Wyatt will just... Wyatt, that is an active chat room of people watching the show.
And
chat
I know rats, nothing about your show, so this is going to be great.
Chat rats, you are now chatting with Wyatt Snack. Now, Connor, you were saying...
Since I'm training for the Olympics, I thought maybe the panel could help me out with doing some Olympic lifts. And basically the way this works is I'm going to lay down on the panel, and I need the front row to lift me to the back row and then shift me over to that end of the panel and lift me back. And then we just repeat until we repeat that.
Will Hines almost just broke a piece of our studio with a French horn. I want to point that out.
So here.
Murph. That mustache. That mustache is a powerful weapon when it comes to hiding.
One, two, three.
Oh no.
Ready?
One, two, three.
Oh, no. I trust you all. I trust you. I trust everybody.
Look at Chris. Look at Chris.
I got it. I'm going behind. I trust you.
This man is no medal. It's
over. You got it?
Oh, God.
Did we make it?
Very heavy. Put him down. Fuck this bitch. He's going to get hurt. Well, Connor, do you feel more prepared for the Olympics right now?
Yes, I do feel slightly more prepared for the Olympics.
I feel like a jerk saying this because I'm kind of a fat fuck myself, yeah. But I feel like you've gained weight since you've started training for the Olympics. Is that true?
It's true, I have. I have a condition where I consume more calories than I burn off.
That's a condition. Yeah. That is a condition.
Yeah. Anyway, that was really helpful, guys. Thanks.
Okay. Let's go ahead to Sean in Boston, I think, is up next. Sean in Boston, line two, welcome to the show.
Thank you very much. First off, I'd like to say it's very unfortunate that we're doing the show sans Horatio.
Yes, Horatio Sands did not appear. Horatio is an unpredictable force of...
I also think he was trying to make a pun.
Yeah, I missed that pun.
Sans Horatio.
Oh, sans Good Horatio. Stuff. Well fucking done, Sean. Well fucking done. It got no one even slightly amused in here. On the panel, but it was a great attempt.
Thank you. Next up, a friend of the show, Mark Wahlberg, his new movie is coming out, and I'm requesting that Grizz would perform the Transformers theme song for us.
Grizz, a request has been made that you perform the Transformers theme show. Sean from Boston, under a misconception that Mark Wahlberg knows about this show.
I don't know the song.
How does the song go, Sean?
Transformers more than meets the eye.
Oh, Transformers.
Transformers more than meets the eye. Oh,
Transformers, robots in disguise.
Yeah. Tomorrow at midnight, Transformers.
All right, Sean, mission accomplished. Well, thank you so much. Oh, fuck. Will Hines now just playing a French horn. Will, I also, you told me you rented that. That is not your French horn. True or false, you rented a French horn tonight to come here. True or false, you took the time
One,
and spent the money
4 seconds, four,
to rent a French horn.
Three.
You rented it. You went to a music store. You took time out of your day. How much does it cost to rent a French horn in 2014? How much does that cost?
Sure.
I'm really ashamed to tell you.
What?
Take your horn and go.
Wow! No! A red card!
Take your horn and go.
Will Hines, eliminate it. Will, the floor is yours. You can try to, take people with you.
I want to, I want to play Send in the Clowns.
Wow! Serendipitous. That seems serendipitous based on what I'm seeing off screen, off stage. So Will Hines is now playing Send in the Clowns on a French horn. Murph desperately trying to focus. This is tickling Murph.
This is tickling Murph.
He said the French horn would be the devil.
I don't mean to take a while.
Murph, you fucker, you're feeling the Send in the Clowns.
I haven't played since 1992, but I'm going to play Send in the Clowns.
22 years. Since you have played this song in a French horn, welcome back to our show. I miss you so much. Okay. Will, I miss you so much.
Do you all know how Set in the Clowns goes? Yeah. You're not gonna know after.
Murph, you open your eyes, Murph. You watch this, Murph. Ooh. Watch Murph, watch Murph! Will, you're about to get Murph. That mustache is starting to tremble. That mustache is starting to tremble, Will! Bring anyone with you?
No, what? No, I want to bring the world with me.
Bring the world with you.
Shame on you.
Clown. We're actually not allowed to throw that in here. Don't throw that anymore. That's against the rules. Don't. That is against MNN rules. For the exact reason you're doing it, we cannot do that. Cool dance is soccer.
Wait a minute. You can kick an elf with scoliosis. We are unable to throw a toy soccer ball.
No sports equipment allowed in the studio. That animal.
This guy's wearing a fucking Foot Locker jersey. What are the rules? What are we a part of, everyone? You see this? It's all a sham. Up is down, left is right.
It's back, my ball is back. We're in love.
Look, I want to answer that question earnestly. You asked me how I was, you know?
Wow.
And I'm disappointed.
Wow.
I'm disappointed to be leaving. There's a community here. And it's not an easy thing to find. You know, sometimes you need people who share in your sense of humor or just something that you care about. You know, whether that's finding community in silence or in laughter, it's something that's going to make me sad to leave. So, Grizz, take my spot up here and own it.
Yes, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Wow. A warm, genuine, touching moment by Jordan Pepper, ladies and gentlemen. Going out classy, going out like a chef.
I think Jordan loves high cheese.
Loves high cheese. Jordan Pepper went out in the exact opposite fashion that Michael O'Brien did. Could not have been more opposite. Ladies and gentlemen, we are down to 6 contestants after starting with many more than that. The 6 strongest remain. We'll be back with a little bit more show, a little bit more Zero Less, but for now, let's blow off some of this steam. They blew the fucking roof off. They played one of Banana Man's favorite songs, which he declared immediately upon hearing it. Hey, Cool Dance and Soccer Clown, stay up here and dance, because we're welcoming back Low Fat Getting Hot.
It's like a warm flannel sheet in a beach house, in a townhouse.
Six contestants back in their seats. We have 5 minutes of show left. Let's really push this thing. What should I do?
Do you want to know what's going on in the internet?
Yeah, what are the chat rats saying?
The chat rats, there's a big consensus.
Somebody say vacation!
Oh, the internet, nobody cares about the internet. That's fine.
Vacation.
I'm the only one.
Yeah, you're the only one.
Literally, no one said vacation.
Try another one.
You said
somebody say Jason.
Jason.
Yeah, y'all said vacation that time.
You guys, I have a message. White men need to relax.
That's true.
Black men need to relax. All men need to relax.
Weird.
Is that weird?
Real weird.
Really weird.
Both white equality. White is okay, fine. I'm the bad guy. I'll be the bad guy. Fuck you. Has anyone ever noticed?
What?
Eat more butts.
Eat more butts.
This whole show.
God is real.
God is real. God is real. God is real. God is real. God is real. God is real. God is real. God is real.
And we have two requests from the chat rats.
Okay.
One is that Juan take off his shirt.
Wow. Woo! Juan, are you okay with that? Now, Juan, you told me before the show you feared you'd be the first one out. You, the underdogger, in our final six. You have 3.5 minutes to go. Do you think you can make it?
The thing about high chews is that...
Say it with your shirt off, Juan.
Yeah.
But Juan, do say it.
White chest, 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 white chest.
Okay, Juan, you were saying, I really want to know, what is the thing about high chews?
The thing about high chews is that when you eat them in your mouth...
You watch them, Murph. Look at that
they get
man.
Stuck. And
stuck?
Stuck?
Stuck.
In the box that's in the back. And it's really hard to take out. Because you have to...
Pause. Either... Keep talking. Everyone, look at Murph. If you grin, Murph, you're out. holding.
Is out?
Yeah. And the internet's looking at you too.
You're looking at me.
Juan, yeah, keep talking.
Because it's like when ice cream is really hard.
You can do this, Murph. You quit heroin. You can do this.
You you have to tap the top part of the ice cream. So
where the fuck do you go?
Whoa! Whoa! I'm trying to work along with the show.
I oversaw
the chat room. They want me to sit on Grizz's lap. I'm sorry, Jason.
I mean,
it's true.
Okay.
They did say Grizz on Grizz.
There's a hashtag Grizz on Grizz.
They did, yeah. Yeah.
Grizz on Grizz.
Grizz on Grizz. Grizz on Grizz.
We have a minute and a half.
Griff on Grizz.
Now Grizz on Griff!
What do you want? Grizz on Griff! Grizz on Griff! This is
what do you want for Griff?
Put your arms down, Murph.
A minute 12!
Oh, yeah!
Murph, do you have anything you want to do, or should we keep it going? We got a minute. Maybe we should just push it. Anything you want to do fast?
I mean, Grizz on Griff, I think, was the best suggestion I've heard so far.
Jason, I really want to apologize for scaring you earlier.
I want to apologize for hurting. I don't know if I hurt you.
Anthony, let's get those high chews out. At 30 seconds, I'm going to distribute the high chews. And we got about 30 seconds left that you guys need to hang in there. You five are about to receive high chew candies. 30 seconds. Anyone want to go big?
I would like to answer Grizz's question. I wish, is it camera two? I wish my parents could learn to talk to each other more directly. I feel like passive aggression is a big problem in my family, and there are issues that need to be tackled head on, and we're all responsible for indulging in that behavior. I'm responsible. My parents aren't watching this.
That seems passive aggressive to me, that you didn't just go to your parents, that you're using a public access.
Congratulations, Quiet. Congratulations, Sammy. Griffin and Grizz. Grizz, what a comeback story, ladies and gentlemen. The winners of the night of Zero Laughs.
Yeah.
Thank you,
Lopec and Hyde. Grizz on Griff. Grizz on Griff. Grizz on Griff.
You won it.